waiting for. Thank you.
Thank you.
cello is Julia. We are missing one member tonight, the other, Julia. She's still in New York. But yeah, so that, thanks for the opening act, first of all. They were really great. Yeah, and thank you all so much for coming out here. That last set we played was called Stomping, because we stomp in it.
When there's fewer cables on the ground, maybe.
Sorry.
And yeah, the next tune we're going to play is called The Epic Reel.
Thank you.
this is a tune that we learned like probably 3 years ago or so, a while ago, at a camp that we used to all go to together, which is called Boston Harbor Scottish Fiddle School, and it used to take place every year in August on one of the Boston Harbor Islands, Thompson Island, and that's like really sort of where we became a band, I guess. We formed there because we were all like campers going there to have fun, take fiddle lessons, and they have a night every week on the island called the Merrymaking, where you can form a band or like make a skit or something with friends and like perform in front of the rest of the camp. And so we formed then, and we were 11 years old, and we were like, we used to hoard candy under our beds to eat like during the week at camp because the food was really bad, we thought. And among those candies were Swedish fish, and we thought it would be funny and like cute if we called ourselves Scottish fish because it was a Scottish camp. So yeah, that's how it started. We were 11, and Maggie was six. And now here we are, and we still have that name. Anyways, this is the Greenland Man's tune. We learned it at camp. We would recommend, we used to recommend that everyone go to the camp, but then it ended. So, we recommend that you could go to a camp. They do exist, fiddle camps. There's a new camp. It's called the Boston State's Fiddle Camp, actually. Started by a fiddler friend of ours, also someone who used to coach and teach us, Katie McNally. You may have heard of her. Yeah. that's going to be this August, I believe. Yes, the 16th, that week of that, yes?
11th.
Okay, good. Yeah, you can look up Boston State's Fiddle Camp. Anyways, Fiddle Camp is it's a great experience if you want to eat candy and start a band.
Thank you.
we're going to play, and then we're going to have an intermission, and then we're going to play for another hour after that. So during this intermission, we have albums in the back that you can pick up if you like what you're hearing. I would highly recommend. We came out with that one, actually, when I think we were 17, but we recorded it when we were 16. We were, and she was like
12.
And then then actually this winter we came out with a new album, which is a Christmas themed album or holiday themed album, which is actually great. There's no copies left, we actually sold out. But there's like a little thing back there, so you can buy it online. But Christmas is over. But if you really want to support us, you can do that. And then actually we're recording a new album this summer, which we're all super, super excited about. We have a Facebook page if you want to be following us there to see when we come out with more stuff and have shows around here. So we're going to play this, and then we'll see you in like 15 minutes-ish.
Thank you.
to do a small group.
It's exactly what it sounds like. It's just small groups.
I think we're kind of a small group to begin with, but it's an even smaller group.
Yeah. Huh. We're going to be playing a waltz called Burt McKenzie's and a reel. No, I don't know what it is, but it's a jig. Yeah, it's cool.
But it has a tune with a very long name, at first, which I don't remember, and then a tune by Alistair Fraser, if you know him, Scottish fiddler.
Yeah. I feel like all the long names ones are like so-and-so's birthday,
wedding, birthday, yeah. Anniversary.
Yeah. For so-and-so's second cousin, lament. Lament. Even lament.
Thank you.
That should be fine.
Thank you.
not out of tune. No, it sounds, yeah, sounds in tune when it's out of tune.
Slow.
Like, okay. It sounds in tune and then it's just out of tune. But you do what you can.
Competitions that you can do with like Scottish fiddling that we haven't done in a long time, but in those competitions you tend to do a march Strasbourg reel,
yeah.
And it's like super, super traditional Scottish, and we don't do too much of that. And then today we were in rehearsal, and we were like, oh my god, we're doing like the traditional like setup of a set. And it was like, wow, we've really come back to our roots. Anyways.
The idea of the framework of a march to Strasbourg is that a march is like kind of slower, like you can think of like bagpipers marching.
Yeah,
like
the little like kilts are like swinging.
Yeah, imagine that for the first part. And then it's supposed to like get progressively faster.
Yeah.
And changes time signature.
Yeah.
Three times.
What? Three times. Well, no. Well,
it's confusing. It's
fine. So many wires.
Thank you.
newest set, I think. We have an abbreviation for it or whatever. It's called PWPCS. If you're really wondering what that means, you can come talk to us after the show.
PWCPS.
Sorry. once again, a little self-promo. I mean, there's CDs back there. We're actually pretty organized. We actually brought them to this concert. Surprisingly, thank you to Cheryl and his mom for going to pick them up all the way in Wellesley. We're not usually this organized, actually. Little story time here. About a year ago, we had this gig at the Roasted Granola Cafe. And we were organized. We brought all our CDs, and then we finally got to the gig, and we got out of the car, and there were CDs all over the back of the windshield.
That's true.
And so it turns out we had left the CDs on the top of the car, and then we drove away. And so then we had my mom, who's right over there, who's also our manager. We had her take our route that we took to get there to find all the CDs that we dropped. And then when she got here with the CDs, she some of them were run over and kind of scratched.
A little beat up.
I think we might have sold them. So yeah.
I'm pretty sure we did, except Walt discounted. Yeah.
They were discounted.
So honest.
Yeah.
Now you know how to get discounted CDs.
Thank you.
But because we released that holiday album, we did like a small tour right around the time it was released, right before the holidays in November. No, December, sorry. And we played, we added a New Year's song to try and make it a little bit more secular. And so, and we kept playing that New Year's song in January, and now it's February, and we decided that we can probably still play it because it's still the new year. Mm-hmm. And it's
pretty new.
And it's a pretty new year.
Yeah.
It's only the second month of the year. And it's a new decade too. So that's what we're gonna do. This is our last set actually. But I wanna feel the question that we actually asked at our last concert. Does anyone know how to pronounce the word that's A-U-L-D? It's just old.
Old.
It's just old.
Well, we prefer to pronounce it ALD.
Makes more sense that way.
Yeah, it does make more sense that way. So we call this one ALD maybe.
Yeah. Only a few people got that one.
Yeah.
Thank you.
last one, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, all you guys for being so great. Also, the St. John's Episcopal Church and Charlotte and the Sound and the ACMI and everybody.
Yeah.
So thank you.
Yeah.
And
also, yeah, the parents, especially.
Oh yeah. My God, yeah.
For driving all the way to Wellesley for
yeah.
the CDs that are in the back that you should
yeah.
buy.
Yeah.
That
right.
And
yeah.
Oh. Well. Catherine, my mom.
Got us
the
burritos.
Yeah.
And Caroline stepped on mine.
Yeah, she got us burritos tonight, and then Ava didn't eat all hers, and then Caroline stepped on it before the concert.
Inadvertently.
Obviously.
Stepped on your burrito.
Yeah.
Anyways,
so
thank you all so much for coming.
Oh, sorry. We're just going to play a big last blast.